In the Middle Ages, the importance of public speaking grew less. The political system was completely different, of course, so citizens were basically left out of the political decision-making process. They couldn't vote and held little political power, beyond the power to rebel. But seeing that the ruler elite were practiced warriors who wielded deadly weaponry and impressive armor, both extremely expensive, even this was usually not much of a choice. Although rhetorica was taught in medieval universities to a small elite, it had by no means the importance of classical times. Not only was there little to no communication science in the Dark Ages, the communication landscape had also changed drastically since Roman times. Alphabecy numbers had dropped rapidly since the decline of Rome. Almost none could write or read, with perhaps some exceptions among the ruler and religious elite. But even among them, evidence suggests readership was not high, and probably very limited to those of very high stations or devoted to academic life in a monastery. It makes sense that written media became less and less widespread. Important mass communication channels were instead oral or figurative in nature. Town criers, architecture, statues, and religious art were still used to reach a large audience. Coins were other examples of visual media that communicated something, typically who was in charge at a certain time. The channels of choice were well suited for communicating who was in power and how citizens should behave. We know the church played an important part in this and worked hand in hand with worldly leaders to get this message through. Often there were agreements between rulers and clergymen that at the end or start of the Sunday Mass, more worldly news on taxes, wars, and basically everything citizens should know was communicated to the assembled people. Since most people went to church, this was for centuries a very effective method to get a message out amongst the people if the need arose. Other media also focused on visual and oral communication. Plays and theater still existed, but theaters did not hold the audiences of thousands as they did in classical times. Although written media had almost disappeared as a means of mass communication, printed pamphlets with etchings or other figurative depictions were sometimes used. Some people might think, they printed pamphlets? Haven't we learned that the printing press was invented in the 15th century by Johannes Gutenberg? Well, actually, the printing press already existed long before this time. However, it was quite expensive to print something, because basically every page had to be carved out in wood, stone, or metal. Because the potential audience that was able to read and pay was small, it was usually simply not worth it. So what was this printing innovation of Gutenberg that everyone always put so much emphasis on? It was actually the very cunning introduction of the cliché, a small letter that could be put in a box to make words and sentences. When the printing was done, the box was emptied and new words and pages could be formed. This innovation made it much quicker and cheaper to print text and is therefore rightly credited as a turning point in European history and a huge catalyst for the Renaissance. Of course, this technical revolution would probably never have had a huge impact if there hadn't been an audience to read and buy books at the same time. This was the result of several long and complicated historical trends towards a higher alphabecy level and the rise of a potential audience with buying power. Not coincidentally, while the mass communication landscape started to flourish again with the rise of print media, scholars again started to discuss the topic of communication on a meta level. So started the Renaissance, not only of art, science, and literature, but also of our scientific discipline.